Hello everyone, I will continue pumps, in that reciprocating pumps. As in the previous lecture, we have studied single acting reciprocating pump. It is a positive displacement pump. One side of the piston is utilized to energize the fluid to lift from sump to the overhead tank here. In double acting pump, same here now, the diagram is same here, double acting pump, just I will remove this arrangement. It is available in the double acting pump also, but for the sake, just to draw that double acting, how it is acting, just I removed here now, but this piston is reciprocating by the external electrical energy. There will be the arrangement of the motor, which is connected to the crankshaft, crank and connecting rod. This arrangement will be there, but that is not showing here now. Double acting pump means only that the difference is here. Both the side of the piston, here is there already we have studied. This side also we can utilize it when the piston is moving from R to L. Here this is a L here, R to L. Also it will lift the water. When the piston will move from L to R, also it will lifting the water. Means both the surface of the piston is utilized to lift the water. That's why it is called as the double acting reciprocating pump. Reciprocatory motion is same, as we have studied already. And how this one, for example, if it is a one huge sump is there, like only one sump here, no? So this is only one sump. We want to lift to that another one overhead tank, or the same overhead tank also we can take here, no? Like the same overhead tank here we can take. The same arrangement here also, there will be the inlet and outlet valve here. Here also that inlet valve, outlet valves are there. Here is the inlet valve for this side, at the right side here now. P1 is the inlet valve, P2 is the outlet valve. At the left side, L, left side here now, P3 and it is a P4 here now. It is an inlet valve, it is an outlet valve here now. This is a total, it is a overhead tank here. So what is happening here in this case? See here. When the piston is moving from R to L, for example, the piston is here, just you see that, if it is moving from R to L, what happens? At the R side, vacuum will create. So, this valve, P1 will be open, P1 will open, the water will start moving inside that cylinder. But simultaneously, so this surface of the piston, L side surface of the piston, it is also moving. So in that cases, the P3 is closed, P4 is open, means this is open here. So what happens? This water available here now, it will be get energized, then it will be lifted to the overhead tank here. At one, R to L, so R to, that means what, L is moving, then which is open here, P1 and P4 is open. Open means water is entering here inside the cylinder. It will happen when it is moving from R to L. And water is already available in the cylinder. It will be energized and goes to that means of P4 to the overhead tank. It is happening. Line is like this here. So next one is, L to R, when the piston is moving from left to right side here, then what are the valves are open here now? Valves open are P2 and it is a P3 are open here. This will open and this will open. What happens? This will open and the water will be starts moving at the L side. It will be because vacuum is created here. Then water at the R side, water will be lifted to a overhead. So, when the piston is moving, whether it is moving to the left side or the right side, when the reciprocating action is happening, both the surface of the piston is utilized to lift the water. Valve opening and closing simultaneously, these are the timings are there, based on the timings, opening, closing will happen. So therefore, that's why it is called as a double acting reciprocating pump here. So this is about the reciprocating pump here. More moving elements, maintenance is more here. Next we will study the, it is a double acting, so it is double acting, please make it that title, you know. The next one is centrifugal pump. Centrifugal pump is somewhat different. Just like turbine, but turbines are power generating machines. Electrical energy is the output. Means, electrical energy means through the generator. But, in case of the pumps here, these are the power absorbing machines. Electrical energy is the input. So, but action will be takes place inside that centrifugal pump. Centrifugal pump is same as the that turbines here. How this centrifugal pump it is there? How this one now? Same as turbine. There will be the shaft here now. On that shaft, there will be the impeller here. So, in this, some blades are there. Rotating blades will be there here. So what is this one now? We are supplying the electrical energy by the motor to this shaft. This shaft will rotate here now. Yeah. When the shaft will rotate, this definitely this rotor or blade. This is a rotor here now. These are the blades are there. This is called as a casing here. As same case casing. This will also rotating here now. Then fluid has to be lifted somewhere in this overhead tank. This is the overhead tank. There we have to lift the fluid. Here is the sump. It has the water at the ground here. We want to lift this water to here. So there will be the inlet, that pipe here. It will be connected somewhere at the eye. This is called the eye. I position, there will be the pipe here, inlet pipe. So it has an inlet valve also here, inlet valve and outlet valve. And we have a pressure measurement here. So it is a pressure measurement. This is a valve here now at outlet, valve at inlet here now. And at inlet also we can measure that pressure, that measurement we can measure it here. So how it will, how the action will take place, just you will see. Sump has a water at the ground level. When continuously this rotor, it is a rotating, continuously at a particular sections, vacuum will be created. When the vacuum will be created, pressure is less. Because of that, water will be lifted, means moving from the higher pressure to the lower pressure. So then we can measure inlet pressure is how much. It is a one-way valve. Then through this one-way valve, it is a moving. Then when it is moving on the surface of the blade, blades have energy. That energy is taken by the electrical energy. that blade will apply that means what certain and supply that energy or transfer the energy to that fluid. Fluid will be energized, then that fluid will be moved in a casing, then it will be lifted through the valve, outlet valve, and pressure we can measure. Definitely this pressure you can take a outlet pressure, P out is there here, P in we can take, P out is always it is greater than the P in here. So therefore continuously it is moving, not intermittent, continuously it is moving from sump to that the overhead tank here. If the rotodynamic action is happening here, so then continuously that water it is moving, is moving. This is called as the centrifugal pump. Somewhere in case of this one, they may ask for comparison between this reciprocating pump and centrifugal pump. Comparison, if it is asked. First comparison, it is a reciprocating action here. The action is reciprocating action, moving to and fro like this in a straight line. It is a rotodynamic action. Roto, that is a dynamic that I action here. Second one, the maintenance is more because moving parts are more here, no? In reciprocal. Maintenance is less here in this case. And the third one is here. It is a positive displacement machine. It is a fixed that a displacement machine here. And cost, coming to the cost per unit power absorption, the cost is more here. Cost is, it is a more here. But unit absorption, the cost is more. That is a, but power per power absorption here. How much power it will take to lift that water? It is, that means what here, more. Here it is less. The next one is, if I compare with that design cost is the, here now, here it is that somewhat it is the medium here, medium design cost because piston and cylinder, but it is somewhat it is high because the blades, rotodynamic somewhat it is lower. Likewise, if we compare for the domestic purpose, this centrifugal pump is useful. So reciprocating pump is used for the industrial purpose in that cases. So therefore, very very important to compare these things. For domestic purpose, centrifugal pumps are used, and for industrial purpose, this reciprocating pumps are used. Domestic purpose, centrifugal pumps are used. So please, my dear students, please go through all the videos sequentially. I will send to you through the WhatsApp this one, and also I will send letter snaps of the books. See, watch all videos, make your own notes with that snaps of the books, keep it with you, and any doubts regarding this matter please discuss with me. Thank you very much.